Hi, everybody. My name is Russell Kirk, and I play the saxophone. And it is New Year's Day, 2023. I'm in my home studio here. And I was recently inspired by a great friend of mine, Todd Marcus, who did a video about his gear and about his setup and about all the things that he uses. So I want to do one too. I want to talk about all the things that I use here in my home studio. One of the things I've been recently working on is a television show on ABC. It's called The Wonder Years. I have a little clip of it. So let's take a little look. This is Dean, a character named Dean, and he plays a saxophone, and his dad also plays a saxophone. So let's have a little listen. I think it'll explain itself.
Hit every note.
You sounded like you were sitting wrong.
Sitting wrong?
Yeah, let me see.
It's as if Jesus came back as a saxophone.
It's as if Jesus came back as a saxophone player. So the character playing the saxophone there, that's Dulé Hill. And the actual saxophone is me playing the saxophone here, recording it here in my home studio. And they use all my takes on the show. I play the saxophone for the father, and I also play the saxophone for the son in the show too. So I have a bunch of different gear that I use. Lots of people have been writing in to me saying, what do you use? What kind of setup do you have? So I want to talk about it. I've got all my stuff laid out. First, let me show you my saxophone. This is a Buffet Crampon Paris saxophone. It's a 400 series. I'm one of their performing artists. I've been playing on the saxophone for over 10 years, and I truly love it. I love all the stuff that Buffet makes. I also play the Buffet clarinets as well. Mouthpieces, ligatures. Let me talk reeds. I've got a lot of different reeds here. Today, I want to talk a lot about reeds and what I use and where they come from. You'll see here, like I said, my blue box is my go-to. But I also have these synthetic reeds. This is a Ligier Signature. This is a size 2.5 as well. I have the brand Berry. These are also synthetic reeds, plastic reeds, basically. So I do dabble with these from time to time to get a different sound, especially if it's, you know, maybe the weather is really humid outside and I don't want to mess with a cane reed. I have a few other kinds of Van Doren reeds. I do dabble with the Javas, the ZZ Jazz, and the V16. However, when I'm using a 2.5 on the Van Doren, I'll probably use a 3 on one of these. I think the Van Dorens are cut a little thicker. I've got Rico Reserves, and I have this brand called Eastman that I also try. But to be completely honest, when I'm going for the optimal sound, I do like to source my own reeds, believe it or not. So I want to take you to where I get them from. So let's go for a little walk. Well, we're going deep into the woods behind my house, and we're going to source some cane. This is a bamboo forest back here, and there's plenty of good stuff for fabricating your own reeds. At the bamboo forest behind my house, and this is a great place to source locally sourced cane that you can dry out. And like I said, I like to come down here, I bring my machete, and I like to, you know, chop down my own stuff and fabricate my own reeds. So with the machete, sometimes if it's a little rusty, that's okay. That oxidation is going to be good for a reed, and you're going to try to pick a good one. Some of these that are bent aren't as great. You want a nice straight one. The bigger ones are better. And then once you take a couple chops, it'll come down. Okay. Now, if you can't get it on the first chop or you don't have a machete, then, you know, feel free to bring in some power tools. This is a DeWalt saw, they call it, a reciprocating saw. And you can put like another blade on here, and this will take it down really quick. Okay, so we're gonna drag this back to the studio, and we're gonna get to carving. Okay.
Royce, get the door.
Much better to read than him. Okay. I mean, he's done it before and all, but like, I think I could read. Okay, let's go.
Okay, so we're back in the studio with our locally sourced reed. We're totally climate controlled in here. And I want to just compare our reed to the factory Van Doren reed. Now, you'll see that, you know, our reed, It has a little more of a warp to it, obviously a little thicker, but this is what's going to get you that really big sound that, that I know that I'm always looking for in my saxophone playing. So honestly, in these scrapes and this rough tip here, that's just going to give you more vibration, and really in the long run, this is going to produce a bigger sound. So when it comes to putting the reed onto the mouthpiece, I'm going to take Todd Marcus's recommendation for this application and use some masking tape. I'm going to go around one or two times for a bright sound. And then if I want to darken up the sound, I'm going to go 3 to 15 times. And you'll see, you can just roll it around here as many times as you like. And you know what, too, you can write your initials here on the tape just in case anyone thinks that it might be theirs. So this is our first application of our reed. I've got some more to show you. Stick around. Okay, so for those of you that saw the locally sourced bamboo, you might not have access to this. Maybe you live in the city. Another great idea for a reed common mouthpiece combination is some old pencils. So this is my pencil jar. I mentioned before, I'm a Buffy Crumpone artist. They send me this great stuff every year. It's got my little name on it. And you can just grab any kind of number two pencil. And what you're looking for is you're looking for a clean break, something like this. You know, something that's got a really good splinter on the end, because we're looking for maximum vibration. When you're applying these to the mouthpiece, once again, I'm taking inspiration from Todd, and I'm thinking rubber bands on this. I mean, there's a little rubber on the end with the eraser, and that's going to give you that vibration that's ultimately going to produce the sound that you're looking for. So once we get a few turns on there, this is going to really give you a great sound. All those shards and even the lead in there with the weight is going to really darken up the sound. So this is another option too if you're going to go homegrown reed. Okay, so I've got the mouthpiece attached to the saxophone, and I have a confession. This application is not producing the sound that I'm looking for. It's not working out. I'm not sure exactly why. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm just trying to trim up a little bit here. And you can just use any old box cutter. And I think if you just kind of come through there and try to get all the way into the lead, I think that that's really going to be where you need to be. And don't worry about these pencil shavings. It's just, you know, they'll disappear. Okay, I think now we're where we need to be. Okay, so hopefully you've liked what you've seen so far. You know, I'm constantly searching for the right sound with my saxophone and my setup and my gear. And sometimes the few applications that I just showed you, they might really not work for what I'm looking for. So I do have another trick that I used to use, and this is sourcing some harder wood rather than the bamboo. I'm going to go for some harder cut. So I'm going to invite my friend Todd Marcus over to the house, and I'm going to get my kids to help me out, and I'm going to show you where we're going to source some hardwood. All right, I'm here with my great friend Todd Marcus, who's been the inspiration for this video. We're back out in nature, and Todd's here to supervise sourcing of some local hardwood that we're going to use for our mouthpiece and reed setup in order to get that really thick, dark sound that I've been looking for. Todd, you're gonna need some protective wear if you can just put these, put these on here. Goggles on.
Ain't none of this up to code.
Okay, so we just sawed down a couple logs. What we need to do is we need to split down the logs. When you're splitting wood, you want to make sure you're using good eye protection. And also, splitting wood, you can get overheated really quick, so make sure you're wearing the right clothing. Okay, so we're back. We've sourced some local hardwood. Todd, thanks for your help. I think what we've got here is a really great final product that we're gonna apply to the mouthpiece. I'm gonna take your advice from your video and I'm gonna go ahead with the screw application. This time I'm gonna use something a little bigger, like a deck screw.
I think that'll work.
And I'm just gonna put this right in. And once you kind of get it all the way,
that coated screw will give a greater resonance as well.
Yeah, and you know what? The fact that it went all the way through the mouthpiece,
yeah,
I think that's going to be okay because this is a vibration.
It's going to enhance the airflow and give that kind of new modern tone that a lot of players are going for these days. So I think that was a smart decision.
Yeah, this is great. You know my son Royce plays the saxophone. Why don't we have him try it out? Royce, I want you to try out my new reed that I made.
Go on, play it.
Okay, I don't know if I can play it.
Thanks for checking out my video. I hope you enjoyed everything. You can check out my music on any of your preferred platforms, Amazon, iTunes, Pandora, Bandcamp. And please feel free to subscribe to my channel. Check out Todd Marcus at his websites and his channel, and I hope you enjoyed everything. Thank you.
How do y'all feel we did?
Pretty good.
I think so. I think we'd probably get this into Sundance at least.
At least.
Probably go viral the next day or so.
Yeah. I'm thinking, nominations of all types.
Yeah.